Coming to us live from Tanga village. Indeed, the UDM has known the pain of loss relating to COVID-19 deaths. Mr. Filtane is the third. The first one was Mr. Mabanda Koko, the second one being Mongameli Bobani, and the third one is Mr. Filtane. Indeed, this is a very sore loss for people of Tanga and UDM at large. He joined the UDM in 2014 and served as a member of parliament from 2014 up to 2019 before being moved to the Eastern Cape Provincial Legislature. But to tell us more about his political career, we are now joined by the Deputy President of UTM, Mr. Ngaba Kwangwa.
Yes.
Mr. Ngaba Kwangwa, I'm sure this is a very bad loss for the party, especially now that this is a third senior person in the province dying as a result of COVID. Take us through that.
Well, these losses, they hit like hell for us as the UDM, primarily because in a very short space of time, we've lost three very strong and great leaders. Firstly, it was Mabanda Koko, former provincial spokesperson. Last week, as you'll recall, it was Mongameli Bobani. And now we are laying to rest Mr. Filtane, who was able to hold the fort for the party here in the provincial legislature. But not only that, many people tend to forget at times that Mr. Filtane was also the national deputy chairperson of the party. So he was an NEC member, quite senior in the party. Yes, he joined the party. He started being active actually in 2013 in the United Democratic Movement. And then in 2014, he became an MP, as you'd recall. I've worked closely with Mr. Filtane, had the privilege of working very closely with him. I mean, he was a warrior. I was not afraid to actually take on any project that he delegated him. And he respected authority, because you recall that Mr. Filtane was more than old enough to be my father, for instance, but I was his senior, both in parliament and in the political party. I was able to delegate him tasks, assign him tasks that he would do to the best of his ability.
Lastly, before I let you go, one outstanding quality he had was calling out thieves for what they were. Very sensitive topic to talk about in a space polluted by irregularities, particularly in the Eastern Cape.
Yes.
Why was he not so afraid of doing that?
It's a culture of the UTM. Remember, we pride ourselves about adhering to the principles and the values of clean governance. So we speak truth to power without fear or favor. So he continued the culture, he lived the values, he espoused the values of the UDM, the anti-corruption campaign of the UDM. So it's easy for us to tell people off, especially when they're stealing state resources or appropriating public funds for private use. So Mr. Filtane did that exceptionally well. He started it in parliament, obviously, and then continued the fight in the provincial legislature. And it's sad today that we have to actually say farewell to him.
Lessons young people can take from that.
I always say that the responsibility, I made this challenge even to the younger leaders of the UDM, saying that the senior leaders are departing, they are leaving us behind. We have a responsibility to pick up the spear and continue the fight, and continue from where the likes of Tata Filtane, the likes of Tata Ntobile Kganyago left off. The responsibility really is on us, the younger generation of this party, to make sure that the fight they've started, the values they have espoused, and everything that they fought for continues to live on forever.
Mr. Kwaga, thanks a lot, sir, for your time.
Thank you kindly. Jabule.
And that's, of course, the UDM Deputy President telling us about the qualities he possessed, Mr. Filtane, saying that he led by example. He championed the fight against corruption. Any moment from now, the UDM leader, Mr. Bandu Olomisa, will take to the stage and address the mourners in this funeral. From us here in Tanga, I'm Kubile Venice, behind the lens, and I'm Yanga Funan. It's back to you in studio, Simpiwe.